Here we go again then. Deep Beats Hit Parade, episode 8. The usual things apply. You can get this on iTunes, which is strictlyum.com/iTunes. You can get it on SoundCloud, soundcloud.com/strictlyum. And you can get us on Facebook, which is facebook.com/deepbeatshitparade. And you can get it on Mixcloud a little bit later on, because we're trying to get people to actually go to iTunes. So if you haven't already, please get on iTunes, download it, subscribe, leave some comments, because that way we get popular and famous, and ultimately we get rich. Yes! For those that haven't listened before, there's I'm Richie. I'm sitting in Auckland in a garage, and Massey is in Rome. Say hello.
What's up?
What's up?
What's up? Jesus Christ.
I'm dwarfed from there.
And he's sitting in a bedroom in... is it a bedroom or is it a front room?
This is a studio, mate.
Studio, sorry. He's sitting in a studio.
It's a bedroom.
It's a bedroom in Rome. Truly international show.
Absolutely.
We've each got 5 tracks that neither of us have heard previously. We're going to play them. We're going to talk about them. And you get to enjoy them and hear what we think of them. And that's how it goes. So, last time, you went first, Massey.
Correct.
This time? Correct. Well done. So last time you went first, Massey. This time I'm going first. First track, here we go.
Listening to Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
Angus Monteverdi. The EP is called La Luz. That's out on Deep Wit Recordings. The remix was Frederick Alonso remix. That's out already on Bandcamp and Tracksource, which might mean Deep Wit's gone completely indie. maybe not. Angus Monteverde, got to say second name, second again, because it makes me sound like I can speak Italian like you, but I can't. He's actually Argentinian, so I only know two Argentinian producers, him and Santiago Santa Maria, and they're both pretty good. So what did you think of that?
It's a good track. It is very long, extended version, shall we call it. But yeah, very, very solid track, without wanting to take away, you know, from the mixer and the producer. It reminds me of what Alvaro would do. Very similar production style, or even the sound. What do you think?
You know, I hadn't thought of it, but yeah, I kind of get where you're going. It's kind of got that warmth and that kind of flow to it that he kind of gets in his track. So yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, and sorry, I should have said, when we say Alvaro, for people out there who don't know what we're talking about, because, you know, Alvaro Highlander.
I get it.
Yeah.
And if you don't know, where the fuck have you been?
Yeah, exactly. So just do your bloody research out there. Just Google it, whatever. I can Google
the best deep house
producer.
The best deep house producer from Spain, exactly. Living in Denmark.
Denmark, exactly. It's easy. Just Google Alvaro, and then you sort it out. But you know, really solid production. Again, maybe a bit long for me, for my taste, but it grooves on you. The risk was that it was going to be one of the, you know, same, you know how it is, eh? Deep house tracks, they all sound the fucking same often. But no, that wasn't the case. Really nice way and subtle way to start the show, man. Good stuff.
Perfect.
Yeah, good stuff.
Perfect. I'm glad that's gone well. Yeah. Usually you go first and I tear the shit out of it.
Exactly. Well, we're not far away from there, because now it's my turn. The track is already playing and I know what you're going to say.
Well, let's have a listen.
Excelente, señor.
Excelente,
señor.
Is that Spanish or is that Italian?
No, it's kind of Spanish, yeah. With the Italian accent.
Listening to Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music. We'll be right back.
Enzo Elia, and the track title is Drifting, and this is out, this will be out, sorry, soon on Free Range Records. It's going to be out in a few days, well, depending on when you're listening to this podcast, 10th of February for the vinyl, and the 17th of February digital everywhere. And the catalog number, because I'm a fussy mofo, it's actually FR222. What do you think of that?
As it started, I liked it. And I know that's going to be a shock to you, because usually I go, nah.
Yeah. You liked it.
I liked it, yeah. But the longer it went on...
There you go.
The more it kind of wound me up. Because it felt quite tense.
Yes.
It felt a bit stressy. You know, things were getting added and strings getting all a bit tense and a bit kind of like, oh, shit, what's going on? And that was kind of making me feel a little bit tense, which... makes me sound like I need to see a psychiatrist. I need a lie down.
Yeah, it is a tense track. I think it's also included. I haven't got it here, but I think it's also included in the promo description, which for once it wasn't crap. They do describe it as a rolling bass line, crisp minimal drums, and a subtly Middle Eastern influence melodic line. Wow. So it's a mystic track. The way
you said the description wasn't crap.
Yeah, sorry, I know. But who writes this stuff? A bit tense. I agree. But I really liked it. I don't know. It kind of makes you want to dance if you're not sitting.
First couple of minutes.
Yeah. Okay.
Maybe that's more about me than anything else, though. I like, you know, morose, lazy music. That was a bit urgent.
It's too much fun. There is too much in it.
Yeah.
Too bubbly.
Yeah. But it's on vinyl. Yeah. So.
It's on vinyl, so we're all happy. All right. Well, okay. Yeah. We are just warming up. And just to tease the peeps out there who are listening. I mean, you know, million of people listening to this show. we'll have to soon change the server because, you know, can't take it no more. Too much traffic. We are going to introduce a new feature on the podcast, but I'm not going to tell you exactly what it is because otherwise you'll skip to it. But you'll have to listen. But keep listening because it's a nice surprise. Right? What do you think? Nice tease.
Yeah. Let's see when we get there. Yeah. I've not heard it yet.
All right, man. Off you go.
All right. My turn. is Matt Cain, Like a Fool. That's out March 10th on the ever excellent Nordic Tracks. Matt Cain was on the last show on Delve Deeper.
Oh, yeah.
So second outing in a row for him. Well done, Matt.
Nice.
EP's got like a who's who of names supporting it, supposedly. My spoiler warning is the EP's got a couple of tracks which are absolutely just dull as shit.
There you
just
go.
Sound like a whole series of parts that you've heard in every other track put together. But that is the shit.
It is. Let me say that out loud. It is the shit. Fantastic production again. I mean, I don't know. I can't help it, man. I love music. Well, I love good music. I get excited about this stuff. I mean, I get goosebumps and shit, you know, even if I'm getting older and older. But great, great fucking production. But I got a butt this time. I mean, not my butt. You know, I got a butt. There you go. This is a rare occasion. Beautiful vocals. Just... what a voice. The way he plays the vocals, the way she was singing, it was just perfect. The melody and the break and everything. Now, the question I have is, what happened to the vocals after you hear the vocals for the first time? I'm like, giving me back more. Come on, drop it. Come on, drop it. Come on, drop it. And they don't come back. What happened there, man?
Oh, it's a tease.
You can't see me, but I'm doing the Italian...
He is doing the Italian finger wagging thing that the Italians could do.
Cosa? Allora, ma che dobbiamo fare qua? Ma insomma, ma...
I'm just going to say off mic. Massey's almost practicing what he needs to say in Italian to remind himself what the English is.
Exactly.
This is what happens when you go to Italy. You forget how to speak.
Exactly.
Totally. He's like, eres meras de veras. I'm trying to figure out what he's talking about behind the scenes. It's very disconcerting.
It's just a mess, man. But no, solid production. It's a shame. Let me just say, it's just a shame that those vocals, I was just kind of waiting and hoping that, you know, waiting for more. But yeah, no, good track, man. Another great pick. Cool. So you're doing well. I'm doing shit, thanks, like always.
Let's see the next one.
And I think you're going to like this one. Let's see.
Okay, let's see.
Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
was Seb Jr. The track title is Getcha Love. The label is another one of my favorite ones. There it's Large Music. And the EP title is Ego Trip EP. Quite interesting. And this is out already. And the catalog number for you fussy mofo out there is Large Music 245. Now, did you like that or what?
No. I'm going with a question first.
Oh God,
what is it about the catalog numbers? Do you like file your music by catalog music in chronological order or something?
OCD, man, OCD. I mean, I can't help it. It's just like,
yeah, what use is the catalog number?
Eh? What do you use them for?
What use is it?
Oh, what use is it? Well, you know, you can actually, if you have like an OCD issue like I do, you wanna have the full package. I can't have
that's
the...
That's useless to anyone. Like, I get it if you've got a record collection like sitting next to me where you're going to put paper recordings in number 1 through to 100. But, like, it's a digit... Anyway, so, Seb Jr. Here we go, then.
Oh, God. So, this is going to be the trashing after the trashing. Go on.
No. I think that one is quality, right?
Oh, wow.
My caveat is that as an artist, Seb Jr., he goes from fantastic stuff to just like so disappointing after such good stuff. And I found that with him on Salted. One release will be fantastic and like that, energy packed. And then the next one will be just a little bit kind of pedestrian compared to that.
Wow.
But that one's got a lot. That's kind of Summer Terrace sizzle.
Yes. Wow. I was expecting the opposite reaction, to be honest. I thought you were going to like it. And then I was like, oh, no, this is too funky for him. It's too happy.
No, I like that.
It's too happy.
I like that. And I'm pleased to see Large doing something interesting again. Because they've had a period of just like, boy, is this fucking bollocks. But that's good. Happy with that.
Fantastic. Look at that. Come on, guys out there, clap your hands together. This is an event. I mean, you know what I mean? Yeah, no, good stuff. I'm glad you liked it. Yeah, I was actually crate digging. And, Large Music. We all know them. But this, yeah, you're right. This got my attention. It was quite different. So good stuff. I picked this one, but if you listen to the EP, it's quite good. It's one of those EPs where all the tunes are actually good. But anyway, yeah.
Cool.
Good stuff, my one. Next track, yeah?
Onwards.
Deep Beats Hit Parade. Brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
Internet. That's tracks called Low Orbit. That's a POAS remix. Could be pronounced terribly terrible. That's out already by the time you listen to this show. 6th of Feb, that's coming out on Beef Records, which most people love. Yeah. The EP is called Liminal State, Part 1. I've already got the promo for Part 2, so they're coming fast and furious. Campaign Internet is the new name for an Australian producer called Gareth Harrison. Build is organic, melancholy electronica. And POAS is someone that kind of pops up and every now and then on my kind of radar. And he's fast becoming kind of like someone you listen to because he's pretty good, I think. What did you think?
I was a little bit...
Hang on. That wasn't there.
I love it. I love everything. All the music is beautiful because, you know... Now, I'm trying to understand the philosophy and the psychology behind this pick of yours.
That would suggest I thought about it a lot.
Because it's like... Wow. That's different. It's such a... Maybe bizarre is not the right word. Very unusual track. Very radiophonic. You know, I can see this played on some really cool fucking radio station, underground radio station. It is a beautiful journey, though. And it's so different from what's out there. Yeah. So bottom line is I fucking love it. Yeah, fuck it. I love this, too. And very interesting change of pace halfway through the track.
Yeah.
You think it's going to just keep you there very, I don't want to say dark, maybe, but, you know, just mellow. A little bit deep, electronic, and then all of a sudden, halfway through it, more or less, it kind of gets this, I don't want to say South African, African vibe, but the instruments I'm talking about. Was there like a marimba or something like that? I don't know. Xylophone? I don't know. Something, it gets happier.
You're the producer, you tell me what it is.
Yeah, I should know better. Now, guys, well, guys.
A different kind of track.
Yeah. Very different, man. Wow. I mean,
see, I like throwing a surprise in.
Yeah, but you know, since we came back with last episode 7, I mean, I don't know. I'm fascinated by this. We should have just like a 15 minutes chat about what's happening in your life with music because there's a bit of a change there. It's very interesting. I think I'm going for the same shit over and over, but this is a good change.
It's good stuff here.
Good stuff, man. Well. Let's see if I'm going to surprise you with the next one. Probably not, but here we go.
We'll see.
listening to Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
That was Finest Wear. The track title is Road to the Core. The label is Del Deeper Recordings. And the this is out of the EP called Into My Soul, which kind of gives you the idea of a very intimate production from Finest Wear. And this is gonna be out in the first days of February, and the catalog number is Delve 025. For your pleasure, pleasure. Did you like that or what? Man, the whole EP is fucking brilliant. Come on. Give me something. Die.
Well, I'm going to start with a question again.
Oh, fuck.
Come on. So,
yeah.
Like, you love Finest Wear.
Hell yeah.
How do you think that rates on the scale of whatever it is, the Finest Wear scale of finery, compared to other stuff?
I don't know, that's a difficult question. Okay, let me tell you something. If I remember well, it's a three tracks EP, right?
That's three for everyone else.
Yeah, exactly. It's a three. This is what I said. It's a three dread tree. There is a tree and some grass. Oh, jeez. Yes, so this is a 2+1 tracks EP. And I think even also because of the title of the EP, I think this is a kind of an introspective journey for Finest Wear. That's why I liked it a lot. It didn't speak to you.
It's definitely different.
Okay.
Like, it feels really rough. And we've talked before about his kind of analog production values and how that gives it this kind of rich warmth that, you know, is nigh on impossible to recreate. This one feels like it in comparison to me, a non-producer, it feels kind of rough and a bit raw and lacking that smoothness that I, like you, really like about Senzel's work.
Yeah.
I love the acid bit in it.
Yeah.
It felt really kind of adept and well-timed and just kind of gave it a little nastiness, which kind of added to that kind of that roughness. But it kind of felt, part of me was thinking, is the mastering a little bit shonky on this or what? Because it just felt a bit boomy and a bit kind of sharp compared to everything else. But I haven't heard the old EP, so maybe yeah. it's kind of in a range there. But for me, it was a bit meh, which is really embarrassing because we usually say lovely things about him.
No, but I can understand. I can understand. I understand your point of view. Well, I mean, you know, it's interesting because the track title is "Road to the Core." So I wonder whether this was like a choice,
maybe.
To, you know, to do something a little bit different in terms of speaking of sounds. But yeah, it is. Okay, let's say this. I think so. For you listening to just this tune, just this track, and peeps out there just listening to this, I can understand why you might think, okay, now it's decent. But I think it's one of those track that you, it's almost like he produced, it's this very tiny album that he did, right? And I think it would give more, it would add more to the track having the possibility to listen to the other two, because they really gel together, they really work together. But I'm not fine, I'm not trying for an excuse, I'm not trying to justify it.
No.
But
it's my laziness that I've not listened to the promo.
No, but that's why I picked it, because we love the guy. I mean, hands down. But,
quality.
Yeah, but you know, just a bit different. Different, sorry. So yeah. Nah, okay, well, overall, I'm doing okay. I mean, there is...
So?
Yeah.
I was thinking now
might
be the chance to bring in the new feature.
Okay, man. Okay, look, because I can't talk for shit, do you want to introduce it?
I always end up doing the talking. So we had this idea.
Yeah.
On Facebook, chatting away, as we do, that we would have a guest track that neither of us had heard.
Yeah.
And we'd kind of critique it. And, you know, we could maybe have different people. But because it was early stages, we had to turn to Paul. And those who don't know, Paul Cassidy's like the spare wheel of this operation. And so Paul's going to pick a tune. He's not here because he's in probably kind of doing granddad things or whatever he gets up to on a weekend. And he's picked a tune. We're going to listen to it. We've tried to think up some cool names for the slot. We've had Jock's Track, which Paul hates because he's Scottish and the Jock thing's a bit offensive. Paul's Pish, Scottish, you know, Paul's Pish Track, whatever. Got Wood, whatever, because he does a bit of decking and things like that. Who knows what we'll call it. We'll probably take suggestions from anyone that wants to leave a comment.
Yeah.
But so we're going to listen to his track and then we're going to talk about it. So this is the track.
To Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
That was our first guest track on the Beats Hit Parade, and picked by Paul Cassidy. Now,
in the newly named slot,
yeah.
Jock's track.
I like that.
He hates it. We love it.
We should have a jingle. Jock's Tracks.
Jock's Trap.
We just listened to this track. First of all, the track is called Corona, I think like the beer, and the producer name is Coyote? I would say Coyote in Italian.
Like the Coyote.
Coyote, there you go. And which label is it? Is that on? No, it's a compilation, isn't it? Head Candy,
yeah,
right?
It's on Head Candy from fucking way back, which probably says more about Paul's listening tastes.
Is that 2011?
2011. What the fuck? So apologies to the label. You've probably done a lot of hard work. Get it on Head Candy, which was probably financially rewarding at the very least.
Hell yeah.
So what did you think of the track?
Oh, I knew you were going to throw me in the ditch.
You go first, then I can get into it.
That is not a Paul's track. There is something wrong here. So I don't know what's going on. I know Paul, I mean, a little bit. I don't know him like a brother or something. But I think I know his taste, musical taste, considering all the mixes that he's done. That is just a bizarre fucking pick, isn't it?
Totally.
I don't know.
I'm thinking it's freezing cold in Scotland right now.
Oh, yes.
He's gone, oh, summer, I'll pick this. Or he's actually got his little boy to do it, because I know he's kind of getting into the music. Whether his little lad's chosen that or what, don't know. But there's nothing wrong with that track, but there's nothing right with it.
I think that's it. That sums it up perfectly.
Yeah. And I'm disappointed in Paul. I was expecting some like left field kind of crazy batshit kind of stuff. But that's just like middle of the road, that. What's wrong with you, man?
So this new feature is going to be a success, because I think what we're going to do is that, you know, we're going to have Paul, probably going to have someone else. We're just going to smash stuff. I love this bit. I mean, this is...
You can hate something.
This is the easy part, man. We're going to make so many enemies out there. That's fantastic.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
What will happen now is he's going to choose something.
Fucking, yeah.
He'll probably choose something on our label.
Oh! Yeah.
And change the name of the file or something like that, so we don't know it. He'll try that, or he'll get something unreleased that's kind of... Anyway, look forward to the Jock's track next week.
I love the name of this segment, man. Freaking brilliant. But yeah, no, we'll have to talk to Bob. I don't know.
Yeah. Or we'll have to replace him.
Back to
my.
Is that your turn?
Yep, my turn.
Oh yes, you're right.
And we're gonna go with someone we both know.
So that is
our mutual friend Dilby, The Things We Do. That's out on Tim Anderson's What Happens label. It's already out. It was out kind of early January. Dilby returning to What Happens again. Other remixes on the EP from Junior G and Die Vogel's Perspective. That's easy for me to say. But that was the original mix. Go.
Well, I think it's too easy. Sorry, this is an easy pick, man. This is an easy track.
You can say what you like. Dilby's too busy to listen to this.
No, I know. Oh, yeah, exactly. It's just too busy producing, too busy playing out. But it's just like, man, I don't know what to say. I mean, it's the production quality of Dilby's latest production. It's good. It's great. Stop. I mean, you can just, he's right. I think he made such a journey. I mean, especially going to Berlin, different influences, meeting people, I guess, playing, especially, and this is what we keep talking about, especially playing out a lot and actually going out a lot and listening to club music. And you can tell that that's what he's been doing for the last years, working hard on everything, because his productions are, I think, are made for clubs. So this is something you play easily in a club, and, you know, people are gonna dance to it, which is interesting. I think it was one of our first episodes. Do you remember we received a few comments on Facebook about the fact that sometimes in these days a lot of producers are just making music in their own bedroom with a laptop or whatever. The reality is they are producing decent music, good music, but it's not necessarily music designed for clubbing, or that is something that would never be played in a club. It won't work. So, well, here is the opposite. So, too easy, man. Too easy. No. I can't accept this track. No, I'm joking.
Nah, your turn.
There we go, man.
You're listening to Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
That was Brookside Chase, aka Christopher Simmons, from San Diego. And the track title is Prove My Love to You, and this is out on Plenitude Records. The EP title is Eternally. It's already out, and the catalog number is... hold on. PNTE001. This is the first track. First track on this label.
Catchy.
First track for this label, man. Come on. Smash it. Smash it.
Oh, Massey.
Oh, God.
No, it's kind of... You've kind of gone back to last time here. It's kind of all of that kind of throwback chuggy stuff.
Yeah!
And to be fair, it's better than that stuff last week.
Oh, God.
But it just doesn't do it for me. It's just kind of like, whatever. I've heard it. Sorry.
You did say that on the last episode. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to throw this in. I want to see if, for whatever reason, it's going to like this better than the last one. But no. I can see a pattern here. Yeah. No, fair enough. You're tired of the same kind of sounding 90s house music with a bass line. Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, I'm consistently critical.
Yeah. Exactly. Well, I'm the opposite. So I love everything.
You just love everything.
Unconditional. Well, that was a failure.
Okay. Sorry.
That's okay. That's all right, man. But
don't worry. You my last track.
Hold on. You didn't even like those lush strings.
Nah, it was just boring. It was better than most. Oh, it's pretty good. Oh, it's all right. Pretty good's gone too far. It was all right.
Oh.
But would you go and buy it?
I would.
Would you?
Yeah.
You'd part with like anywhere between $169 to $299 US dollars for that?
Well, $299, that's a bit steep.
You see?
Okay, your turn.
My turn.
You're listening to Deep Beats Hit Parade, brought to you by Strictly Underground Music.
Title, God help us. That is Samuel. Am I really going to say this? Samuel. Oh God, Samuel Fach. F A C H. God, I never even thought about it. Anyway, Samuel Fach. That is. Picture Be Wild featuring somebody Gerstenberg and it's
oh god
and it's the Jonas Sosalbach remix.
That is the longest fucking title ever. I'm never gonna remember that this shit.
Chilling, that's out on Chilling Music. It's on a compilation, Chilling 16. Catalogue number, who gives a fuck? And it's already out. Jeez.
Oh my God, I'm crying here. Oh God. Oh, that was hilarious.
Oh, you better like it.
Wow. Oof. Yeah, what a fucking title, man. That's so long. I mean, I would just call it track one, honestly. Just
yeah.
Really complicated stuff. Now, really fucking long again. I mean, yeah.
7:52.
It's like 8 minutes or something. 7:52. Yeah, but it was getting it was dragging a little bit in the first bit. I mean, very, very kind of deep and dark, and I don't know. I could see this as an early track to warm the club up, or maybe like early morning, you know, when they're all just fucking going for it. And maybe early morning could be a better journey, actually, I think. Mm. And this, I don't know why, one of my few club experiences, this reminds me of this, I could see this being played in the dark room at Fabric. You know, just sweating like a pig. And there is really no space for dancing because it's so fucking full of people. But you don't care. You're just shedding.
Just rubbing against someone else.
You're like some hairy dude or, you know, shedding sweat with other people. You're all in it together. It takes a while to grow on you. But I guess, you know, again, the context which we are listening to these tunes often is not what it should be. All of that to say, change the fucking title of the track, make it short. Awesome.
To be fair to him, if Samuel Fach had gone to our school,
why would you?
He would have been pilloried every day, the poor little git.
I know.
Anyway, Picture Be Wild featuring Koja Gertensberg, Jonas Salbach remix.
Yeah, great remix.
Chilling Music, Chilling 16 compilation. And I thought it was kind of one of those kind of tracks that you just kind of get lost in.
Yes, exactly that.
And I like that. And it's really miserable in places, which is perfect for me. Really cheers me up. Okay. Your turn.
Okay, is this my last one?
Oh, it is.
Fortiba, the track title is Atlas, original mix, and this is out on Deep Stitched, which is another label that I really respect and really like. And it's this EP, it's almost like a compilation, it's various different artists, and this is called Get Stitched Volume 1. And it also says selected by Kicks Bantam, and I don't have a release date, it could be out already, and the catalog number is DS030. Did you like that? Come on, tell me you liked it.
I thought it was kind of enjoyable bar music. You know, the last one was all clubby. This one's kind of bar music.
Yeah.
No one's going to be offended by it. Would I buy it? No.
I mean, you leave me without hope here.
It was kind of, it was just one of those ones that's kind of like, yeah, it's nice. I don't mind it. I quite enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But kind of did it set the world alight? Has it got anything that made me go, oh, that was... memorable, like if you'd like had it in a big crate of music and you kind of popped it on to kind of see whether or not it was going to be your next track, you'd kind of go, yep, that's all right. But it wouldn't be kind of one of those highlight songs of a set or anything like that.
And fair enough.
But it was solid.
Yeah.
It was solid, dreamy, enjoyable kind of bar music, which, you know, nothing against that. I like a bit of bar music.
Yeah. They do. The label, as you know, it is very, very deep. Very at times very mellow. I think it's just they went for this style. So the old compilation is.
What was the label again? I was drinking beer when you were talking about it.
Of course. Deep.
Sorry.
Deep Stitched.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. They have they have a very cool branding as well. I like that. I like that logo.
They do, yeah.
I like that.
I can't remember whose label that is.
No, me neither. But,
Escapes me. But yeah. They do some stuff. Nice stuff. Deep, yeah. But kind of whatever.
Yeah, fair enough. So on episode 9, I'm not going to be here because you...
I'm just going to play my own music. Yeah. I love this one. I like this one.
Oh, fantastic, man. Fantastic. But... Well, that was good. That was good. It's good to be back into rhythm, you know, getting back into the groove, like Madonna was saying. Is that what she was saying?
Have we decided to ditch the deeper, meaningful bit, or have you thought of one?
I think we should go back to it because I got like, I don't know, 240 emails with people begging, asking, you know, hey, can you go back? Can you put that back in the slot? Look, we're really fucking busy, guys. I mean, we can't always answer all the emails here. So I think we are kind of forced to do so. But...
if the public wants it.
I mean, you know, what do you do? There is a little problem. It's that we don't have a topic, do we? So unless you can think of something. I don't know. We could ask people, what do you want us to bitch and moan about?
I mean, I don't know. That... No, I like that. Why don't we on this one on iTunes?
Yeah,
which you can download at strictlyum.com/iTunes.
.com/iTunes. Yeah,
you could leave a comment about what we should talk about.
On
Facebook or whatever.
Yeah,
let's be honest. We'll take any
anything at this stage.
Anything.
Yeah,
and then we could talk about it. Otherwise, I'm just going to start picking on people that annoy me on social media.
Well, that could be a thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the people that send you a promo that they've sent to 7,000 people saying, will you sign it? Or people that send you a promo that's already out and say, will you sign it?
Well,
it's out already, dick.
What do you mean it's already out?
It's already released, dickhead.
What?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah. Look,
what?
There's amateurs everywhere. Yeah.
But there must be like a glitch in the system. Maybe the email didn't.
No. They just on Facebook. Or people sending you voice messages on Facebook.
What are they doing? What?
Yeah. Voice messages.
What? Like, a little while saying what?
I don't know. I don't listen to them.
Well, that was easy. So people are there.
Yeah, it's set up so it just automatically responds to any email to the label to say, if you're sending about demos, go to the website. What is that? Don't send me a voice message. That's just stupid.
So people out there, now you know, if you want to send them, don't fucking leave voice messages, because that's not good. I would be curious.
No, I'd
be curious to know what they're asking for, though.
No, I'm not listening. I know some lunatic keeps sending Paul voice messages on Facebook Messenger as well.
Does he listen to
about
him?
Some? No.
No. So we don't have a chance.
No, I think he did listen to one of them. It was in Russian.
Is that a real thing?
Yeah. But, you know.
What?
Paul doesn't speak Russian.
I mean, what? That's odd.
Yeah.
I think.
Anyway.
I think, I don't know, sometimes I wonder what are we still doing on Facebook? In general, man. Like for a promotion, you know, point of view. I don't know. It's not. I don't want to get into this right now, but I feel like it's really not working anymore, man. Did I tell you?
No.
I was poking around and making a few experiments, as I do, because I'm a geek and a nerd all together, and I love this stuff. And I was just like, okay, I'm gonna run an ad on Facebook about music and see what's gonna happen. So I don't know. It's all dodgy and shifty. You get the results from the ads and it says, 435 people. This is their age. This is where they came from. They actually clicked on the link, but then there is no follow through. So it's like, what are we doing here? How is it possible that 2,500 people clicked on a link, but then actually the link was actually going straight to a product? Let's call it a product, you know, to buy a product. All you have to do is like buy. And that was it. And there was not a single freaking sale. I mean, that's... Well, two options. The product is absolutely fucking shit. That could be the option, but I don't believe it's the option. Or two, someone is lying here. Whether the platform that I'm selling the product on is actually keeping all the money, or whether Facebook is just lying about these fucking ads and stats, man.
Ooh, that's that is deep. That is deep and meaningful, isn't it?
I don't know. It's just, man, I don't know. I mean, it's almost like we are forced to, no, we are, but well, we are all forced to be on it. Because if you think about it, it's there and Instagram. I mean, it's the place to be, but is it really working? Because I don't think it's working. It's almost like I'm seeing all these people putting a lot of effort into promoting and, oh, look at here, look at there, all these labels, and tiki tu et takata, buy the music. And but what's the reach? What's the you know what I mean? Who's seeing this stuff anyway? Your mum? I mean, what's the fucking point? I don't know. Mate, you run a label. Do you see any benefit? I mean, is there a benefit from actually being on Facebook? There you go.
No, and as the ever wise Tim Anderson said to me, well, all that really matters is how many followers you've got on Beatport.
Ah. So that's it.
And things like that. You know, that's the only way people sell money. People sell records.
Yeah.
And make money. But, you know, that's fairly depressing for every new producer, isn't it? If you've got to have a lot of followers on Beatport, then you can't make any money if you haven't got followers. So, until we've got anything better, we're just going to have to persevere and, you know, hope that people decide that stealing music isn't quite as a good idea as it was, because it just means you're listening to something different.
Yes, something unusual.
Something unusual and something kind of dodgy. Anyway.
I think there's too much stuff out there. So it's like you don't know where to point people anymore. Almost like with podcasts right now. You need to be on SoundCloud, but you really need to have people going and subscribe on iTunes. Otherwise, what's the fucking point? But obviously, there are too many platforms, and I think it's almost like you spread yourself too thin.
And I agree.
And the end result is like one click there, one track sold there. But yeah, it's too many things. Which reminds me, man, talking about, you know, advertising and Bandcamp and labels trying to survive, especially indie labels in these days. I was reading this article, I don't know if I sent you the link, about Spotify. I got it on my phone actually, and it's fucking insane. Did I send it to you?
No.
Hold on, people out there, give me 35 seconds because I'm gonna pick this up. There you go. So this article, right? The website is called I'm never going to be able to say this, the Tricordist, I don't know, that website. So, apparently, songwriter, this is the title, songwriter would need 288 million spins to equal the average Spotify employee salary. Now, can you believe that? Can you actually believe that? And according to these pips, Spotify has just posted their financials, right? And basically, apparently, the average Spotify employee salary is, brace yourself, $168,747. What?
Someone's making money.
I mean, you know what I mean? And so basically, these guys are arguing the fact that, okay, these guys are making so much money. And like John Doe, to earn the reported average salary, like it says on the article, yeah, we're talking like crazy figures here. So going back to the labels trying to survive, what the fuck is going on here, man? This is just completely wrong.
And that's why everyone's ending up on like Bandcamp, because, you know, the perception is that you get more money back in your pocket.
Yes.
The fact is, as you rightly said, by spreading it thinner, you're just kind of spreading the actual amounts of people who've taken a percentage away from you. You know, Bandcamp still take a percentage, Spotify take a huge percentage.
Yeah.
Beatport take a percentage, Traxsource take a percentage, the distributor takes a percentage,
the
label, most labels take a percentage.
Yeah.
Everyone's taking a percentage. Yeah. The thinner you spread it, the more people are taking a piece, and you know, it's a vicious circle. Technically, the only way to make any money is an artist to make his record, master his record, and sell his record only to people that buy it direct from him, and he gets all the money.
And that's it.
The problem with that is he wouldn't have any time to make any music because he'd have to be promoting it all the time.
There are too many middlemen, and but at this stage, yeah, you're right. You can't make without them,
right?
I mean, can make without a few of them, but again, it's like for you as a label, whether you're gonna decide to use like one of those platforms that promotes the music, that sends the promos out, or whether you don't. You do, and you benefit from it, but you have to pay them, and you don't, and fuck, you need to do a truckload of work to promote your music.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know, man. It's yes.
Don't have the answers. You just gotta keep trying shit and seeing what works, and hoping that as a community, people buy the music and help promote the music, which is what we do here.
Yeah.
Well, fuck, that was depressing. That was depressing, man.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Anyway, so if you've not slit your wrists, you could subscribe to this on strictlyum.com/iTunes, and obviously subscribe or download it, and then you can leave comments and we can get rich and famous from all of the people's music that we don't pay for. You can listen to us on SoundCloud, soundcloud.com/strictlyum. You can get us on Mixcloud, but we don't put it up there straight away. It comes a little bit later. And of course, you can like us on facebook.com/deepbeatshitparade. You can also find us on the Strictly Underground Music website. There is a subpage which has got the shows and a little bit of info, and it's got track listings and things like that. Head over there and check out Massey's wider Strictly Underground Music project.
Come on.
And we will be back for episode 9 soon, once we've found some more tracks that Massey thinks is good and I don't.
Good stuff, man. It was fantastic as usual. And to the beeps out there that keeps listening, thank you so much. Can we just say that, man? Because I mean, it's nice to see that there are a few peeps who are quite interested in the show. They like the music that we are playing. Some they don't, which is great, which is just fantastic. But yeah, thank you for your support so far. Let us know what you think of the idea of having a guest track in the show. And most importantly, let us know what you think of what Paul picked.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, next time, eh?
Next time. Ciao.
Ciao.